seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to these tenants when he comes? They answered him, he will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper times. Jesus said to them, did you never read in the scriptures? The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit. The gospel of the Lord. My dear friends, last week, for those who were present with us, we reflected on keeping promises, because making promise is what we do often. We make a lot of promises, but the real deal is in keeping those promises. And I'm sure at the time you took time to reflect on your own and recognize how often you break your promises to yourself, to others, and even to God. But today, God wants us to talk about accountability, being accountable. That's not something we do very well. I don't know about you, but as many people as I have known, at least 95% of people struggle with being accountable. It's not something that is natural for us to do. And so very often we experience resistance. We get into fights because we don't want to be held accountable. When you read Genesis chapter 3, you read from verse 9 following. You see, when God first came into the garden to hold Adam and Eve accountable, the moment he entered the garden, the first thing Adam did was, because of the asymmetry of power, Adam was a lower being, God was God. So Adam was afraid of God. So he ran and hid himself. He ran together with Eve, and they hid themselves from God. So when God entered the garden, he says, Adam, Adam, where are you? He says, I heard your footsteps in the garden, and so I hid. He says, why are you hiding? Have you eaten of the tree I told you not to? Says, well, the woman you put here with me gave me, and I ate. And then God called Eve. Why did you do this? Well, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. And so you recognize how the first thing Adam did after his violation of the instructions God gave him was he had to hide himself. He went into hiding. He did not want to be held accountable. And then when God found him and held him and tried to hold him accountable, he blamed it on God. The woman you gave me, if you had just left me by myself, this may not have happened. But the woman you gave me, she gave it to me and I ate. Then God turned to Eve and says, what have you done? Says, well, the serpent. So you realize how everyone is passing the blame, passing the buck to the next person. No one wanted to be responsible, be held accountable. So from our first parents, being held accountable is something human beings, we've struggled a lot. But there is, in the principles of God's creation, accountability is one of the building blocks. If you want the blessings of God in your life, you have got to learn this principle. You've learned to become accountable for what God has given to you. Now, if you listen to that gospel text, even the first reading speaks of a landowner. He built everything. He did everything himself. The hard work was done by himself. All he did was he leased it out to tenants. He says, you take care of this for me. You take care of this. You be the custodian of what I'm giving to you. And they mishandled it. They misused it. They didn't do a good job. Now, for everyone who is sitting down here, that's what God has done. God is a land owner here. He owns me. He owns everyone who is here. He owns everything that we have. Whatever you have, whatever you are, it's a gift from the Almighty God. He is a land owner. As we hear in the responsorial verse, the vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord is whatever God has given to you, beginning with your own life. Create your spouse. If you have children, your children. If you are a teacher, your students. If you are a nurse, your patients. If you are a priest, your parishioners. And whatever you are, people that God has placed under you, that is God's vineyard. And you are its custodian. Now, when you read 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1, this is what Paul reminds us. It says, people must think of us as dispensers, or in other words, people must think of us as stewards of the mysteries of God that is meant for God's people. So as custodians, as stewards, our job is service. And if I am serving, I must be held accountable. I must be held accountable. Now, I want you to think about it. How difficult it has been in your own marriage for you to hold each other accountable. Some of the fights you guys have had in your family is when one spouse tries to hold the other one accountable. That's where the fight comes. Now, I saw you on the Facebook page. Who were you looking at in that Facebook page? That's where the fight comes. What do you mean? What was that supposed to mean? Now, they just ask you a question. Answer the question. Don't become defensive. When you become defensive, what you're saying is, I cannot be accountable to you. What right have you to ask me that question? Now, when that person gave you their heart, they also obtained the right. They also, immediately, when your wife or when your husband says yes to you in marriage, you immediately ceded to them the right to hold you accountable. It's no longer in your power to choose when and how to be held accountable. She has the right to hold you accountable. He has the right to hold you accountable. But think about how many times people fight in their families because they don't want to be accountable. Whether on a phone call or a text message, I saw a text message on your phone. Who sent that? Let them know who sent that to you. Don't get into a fight and become defensive and begin to attack and lash out and blame them and cajole and sometimes even blackmail. See what was happening in that gospel text? That's what happens when we are not responsible and not accountable. These guys were given a vineyard. We're not sure how they used the produce. Maybe they sold and spent the money in whatever lifestyle. But when the time came for the master to ask for the produce, they decided to put up a fight because they had not been responsible on how they handled the produce. The same thing happens. You don't put up a fight if you haven't responsible. You say what happened. The only time we get into fights is when we have been irresponsible. When we have not done the right job. That's when we begin to put a fight. And God says, I care about how you are accountable. Now, this is what the Bible said. If you are not faithful in small things, there is no chance you'll be faithful in big things. What God is saying is, if you cannot show me that I can hold you accountable for small things, there is no chance I will give you big things, because the way you act in small things is the way you will act in big things. And sometimes we wonder why we struggle through life, because we fail to observe the very simple principles that God has laid down for us. Now, for all our children, I know how difficult it is for you to be held accountable by your parents. Sometimes you think your parents are not good parents because they're trying to hold you accountable. When your dad will say to you, says, okay, I'm giving you 3 hours to be with your friends, you come back 4 hours later. Why are you coming back late? You get angry, you get upset. You think your parents are not allowing you to be yourself. No, your parents have a responsibility over you. And their job is to hold you accountable. If you agree with your parents, I'm going to be out for 2 hours. Come back in 2 hours. Be responsible. Hold yourself accountable before you are held accountable. Because it matters. If you want God to bless you, as you grow through life, you must learn the lessons of accountability. You must learn the lessons of being responsible for whatever is entrusted to you. Time, self, assignments. They give you assignment in school. Don't come back and then go into everything else. Hold yourself accountable. Get the assignment done first. That's how you learn. Because you just can't become, grow up one day and then wake up one morning and become an accountable servant or an accountable steward. You learn the virtues of accountability. And God is saying to us, says if we don't, he will take whatever blessings he has given to us and give them to people who will handle it and manage it very well. Just read the very last verse in the gospel reading. It says the kingdom of God, that means the blessings of God, will be taken from those who have failed and given to those who will do a better job. So whatever God has given to you, my dear friend, take it and do what it's meant to be done. Hold yourself accountable. Because when you do, you open the treasures of God's blessings in your life. Those are not my words. They are God's. And so I want you to take a moment today as you go, as you think about this in church or as you go back into your home. How accountable are you in your marriage to each other? How accountable are you in your marriage to each other? How accountable am I in my ministry as a priest to my parishioners? I have seen churches where the pastor sees himself as a king of that church. So no one can hold him accountable. No, that's not what God said. God said, I'm a steward. I'm a servant of his people. There's only one master in this place, and it's Jesus Christ and the people. Sometimes I say to myself, if as a church we allow ourselves to be held accountable, this church will still have all of these pews filled up in every church. But there are so many people who left us because they just couldn't handle a people who could not be held accountable. Think about how many people left us because of the child abuse. Why did they leave? They didn't leave because there were some bad priests out there, but because we failed to hold these priests accountable. That was why they left. We failed to be accountable. That was why they left. And I think we fail not just as an organization. We fail as a government. We fail as people. We fail as independent people, individual people, when we refuse to be accountable. And God is saying, I care about people being accountable. Whether as a government, as a church, as families, as persons, I care about people being accountable. Because unless you are accountable, there's not much I can do for you. There's not much I can do with you. So we pray, dear friends, don't resist being accountable. Be humble. It says a lot about you. Be humble. Be responsible. Because when you are humble and responsible, you don't fear being accountable. You smile to it. You do it with pleasure and with grace. You don't fight. You don't scream. You don't yell. You don't cajole. You don't blackmail. We destroy our relationships by a lot. Think about the distances we create in families because of that. I pray, dear friends, that God, who has blessed us with everything that we have, will also help us to use what he has given us well, just so we don't fear to be accountable. We don't need the police to hold us accountable. We don't need legal systems to hold us accountable. You be accountable. Hold yourself accountable. Make yourself accountable. And see what God will do with you in 1 year, 365 days. And see how your life will change in 1 year, 365 days. May God bless you. May God give us the grace to use wisely every grace and every opportunity and every blessing that he may give us, just so he could expand the favors in our lives. So I'd like to end my reflections by reminding you that you are the delight of God Almighty. God loves you very much. The Lord be with you. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God. Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in the one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Most gracious God, hear these concerns we are about to raise before you. You know the struggles in our hearts. But today we ask for grace, grace to be accountable. Accountable to ourselves, accountable to each other, but ultimately accountable to you, even as we pray for all our other needs.
For all bishops, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide them in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For lawmakers, may the good justice guide them in living out their duty with wisdom and a sense of service to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who struggle in faith, may the Lord console them with his promises and help them in any unbelief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may the calling of Christ echo in our hearts, giving clarity to our desires and actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For men and women to be open to the voice of the Lord, asking the Holy Spirit and the Blessed Mother to help them recognize and answer his call to serve him as a priest, deacon, or in consecrated life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may be the welcome in the kingdoms of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us ask our Blessed Mother to intercede for us as we say, Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our lives, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sight, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, your eyes of mercy towards us. After this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Amen. Please sit.
Thank you.
pray, my beloved sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our mighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church. Amen. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifice instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess a pledge of eternal life. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, the Lord Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the Lord took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and this chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Timothy, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have placed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us rise and pray in the words our Lord gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live forever and ever. Amen." The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always. Dear friends, let us wave to each other the sign of God's peace. Look up, my sisters and brothers, and behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please sit for a moment.
We need two counters for the collection. They need to be 18 years or older and not related to the other counter. And when we get to the final song, it's number 381. We don't have any pistolets. Take the word of God with you.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to make a quick announcement. There will be no class for religious ed next weekend because it's a holiday weekend, so we usually follow the school schedule. Also, the schedule for the rest of the year will be by the sign-in sheet back to the church there, or chapel there, and just take one home. And God bless.
Before the final blessing, I'll take a moment to express my thanks to our altar servers, our music team, our lectors, Eucharistic ministers, and I'll thank in advance two people who will help us count the collection today, those who would volunteer to count the collection today. So thank you for everything that you do. We appreciate your service and your grace. We also like to say thanks to everyone here for being present. I pray that this week will be a better week for you, that you may find God answer your prayers, and it's one of the things you've been asking for a long time. October is the month of Our Lady. In case you do not remember, that's why I think some of the songs were songs dedicated to Our Lady. So if you can, it doesn't hurt. It can only do you a lot of good, if you could spend some time in your family. If you can't pray the entire rosary, at least say a decade of the rosary with your family every day for the next 20-something days. I have no doubt that what Our Lady did to Zechariah, Elizabeth, and John the Baptist could also happen in your home if you can allow her to spend time with you in your home. Today is also the feast of St. Francis of Assisi. If it wasn't for a Sunday, we'll be having a Mass of St. Francis. And that's why you heard one of the songs there dedicated to St. Francis. So if you are Francis, or Francis is your patron saint, happy feasting. On Wednesday, this week, Wednesday, the Archbishop for Military Services, has asked that all of us, all Catholics, join in the Rosary for America on Wednesday, the Rosary for America. So at 3 p.m., 1500, the Archbishop will be leading a Rosary for America. So wherever you are, if you can, at 3 o'clock, you could join in praying the Rosary for America. If you are able to join the Archdiocese through the face Archdiocese, for Military Services Facebook page, you could join and participate directly if you can. Otherwise, just do a rosary at your own time, at your own pace, on Wednesday at 3 p.m. Last week I talked about the RCIA. If you know someone, or you are someone who would like to be baptized, be confirmed, do First Communion, or maybe be received into the Catholic faith, please contact me, Rowana, Father Aswe, or Deacon Rich, or anyone else who might bring you to us. And if you know someone, please direct them to us. We're here to help and to do our best for them. I'm sure you didn't see our missalettes today. There's a change in policy. Beginning this week, it only happens in the middle of the week. But beginning this week, all services on post will no longer have missalettes until we're able to have a better grip of this virus. So we will only have to depend on the choir. And it's not just the Catholic community. It's all services across the board. So that's what was agreed by leadership and then passed over to us. CWOC will also not be able to have child care for some period. We're not sure for how long that will be, and we're sorry that this may bring some layer of stress and inconvenience, but I hope that we're able to resolve that very quickly. And finally, Financial Peace University started a training or lecture, started last week, Tuesday last week. So for every Tuesday for the next 8 weeks, there will be a lecture here in the chapel. That is a very good training, believe it. It's a very good training. It has helped me to manage my own finances better, and I have no doubt it will help you to manage your finances better. Say the difficulty in life is not making money. It's managing money and knowing your relationship with money. So we pray that people you guys may be able to make time and attend the next 8 classes. You could never lose doing that. And if you forget everything I said today, please don't forget this, that you are the delight of God Almighty. Do we have any birthdays today? Any birthdays? Tomorrow? Sorry, not today, this week. So tomorrow. All right. Who else for birthday? Oh, 2 of you? Wow. All right. Choir, please. Anniversaries? Any anniversaries? Anyone? Anytime soon? This week? Anyone join for the first time today? All right, so let's give a blessing to our brother and our sister. Stretch your hands towards them, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just want to give thanks and praise to you for every good favor you grant. Scripture tells us, whatever 2 or 3 agree and ask in your name, that you will grant. There's power in common agreement. And gathered here, we agree to ask this favor and this blessing for our brother and our sister as they celebrate their birthday. Grant them many more healthy and joyful and prosperous years, O God. Protect them, and may this day be the beginning of new things in their lives. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Went up. Okay. That was like an angel visited, right? So please remember this, that you are the delight of God. Love yourself. Love people God has put in your life. And I can tell you, God will spoil you with love. Love yourself. Love the people God has put in your life, and God will spoil you with love. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and ask God's blessings. Most gracious God, watch over your children as they go into this week with all the scheduled events and plans in their lives. We ask your blessing. Watch over them, protect them, and keep them safe. And when this week is over, may we even have greater cause to give thanks and praise to your holy name, because we have answered all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Through the prayers of St. Michael the Archangel, St. Francis of Assisi, and our Blessed Mother, may God bless and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Dear friends, this Mass is ended. We go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and sinners of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits that prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.